In this video, we are going to see a problem under 4A series. In that too, we are discussing about odd and even function cases. So look at this question. Expand f of x is equal to x into pi square minus x square by 12 in minus pi comma pi. So in the interval minus pi comma pi, that's why we are checking for that odd and even cases. How to find out odd and even case means, first we have to find out whether the given function is an odd function or even function. For that, what we have to do, we have to replace x by minus x in the given f of x so that we can get the answer whether it is odd or even. So put x is equal to minus x in given f of x. So what will happen in the left hand side, f of minus x equal to, wherever x comes we have to make it as minus x, so pi square minus minus x the whole square divided by 12, which is equal to minus x into pi square minus minus of x the whole square, that means it is plus x square divided by 12. So what will happen, f of x we are replacing, so you are getting like this, you take the minus outside, so x into pi square minus x square by 12, that is nothing but f of x. So f of minus x is equal to minus f of x, that means given function is an odd function, therefore f of x is an odd function. So f of minus x is equal to minus f of x, therefore f of x is an odd function. As we discussed already that for an odd function, a naught equal to 0 and an equal to 0 for odd function. Okay, so only we need to find the value for bn. Okay, so bn equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x sin nx dx. So substitute our f of x, 1 by pi minus pi to pi f of x is x into pi square minus x square by 12 into sin nx dx. So now we are going to integrate that. Before integrating this, we will take the 12 outside. 1 by 12 pi into integral minus pi to pi x into pi square minus x square into sin nx dx. Now look at this function. Here x into pi square can multiply with x also. So 1 by 12 pi integral minus pi to pi pi square x minus x cube into sin nx dx. Now given f of x is an odd function, sin is also an odd function, so odd into odd equal to what, even function. So this can be written as 2 by pi integral 0 to pi pi square x minus x cube into sin nx dx. So here we have multiply odd function into odd function, that is equal to even function. So given f of x is an odd function, sin is also an odd function, odd into odd even function. Because of that property only, this can be written as 2 times of integral 0 to pi pi square x minus x cube into sin nx dx. Now we are going to apply the Bernoulli's formula. We will take this term as u and sin as a v term. You can get the Bernoulli's formula. So applying the Bernoulli's formula. So now we are going to apply the Bernoulli's formula. We will take our u as pi square x minus x cube v as sin nx. Differentiation is u. So u dash equal to pi square is a constant. Differentiation of x is 1. 3x square differentiation, sorry, minus x cube differentiation is minus 3x square. Again differentiating this, pi is a constant, so that will become 0. And minus 3x square differentiation, minus 3 means minus 6x. When you are differentiating the third time, we are getting minus 6. If you are going for the next one, it will become 0. So we will stop up to third derivative. Now v equal to sin nx, integration of v is minus, so minus cos nx by n. Again integrating this, minus is there, integration of cos is sin, already one n is there, so this will become as n square. For the third time integration, minus, sin integration is minus, so minus into minus, this will become as plus, cos nx by Already n square is there, one more n, so we can get n cube. So again integrating this, we can get v4, that is sin nx by n power 4. Now we are going to apply the Bernoulli's formula for this bn. So already 1 by 6 pi into u, so u is pi square x minus x cube, then v, so minus cos nx by n minus pi square u dash, applying the formula. So integral, Bernoulli's formula, many times we have repeated, integral uv dx equal to uv1 minus u dash v2 plus etc. So applying this result, you are getting this term with the limit 0 to pi. We know very well that wherever with the limit 0 to pi with sine term, that will become as 0, because multiples of sine pi is 0 and sine 0 is 0. So before applying the limit itself, we can get the, we can make the sine terms as 0. So only you are getting these two terms. For the upper limit is pi, lower limit is 0, limit only for x. So when we are applying the upper limit x, sorry, here we are applying the limit, upper limit pi, pi square into pi, that will become as pi cube, and here also pi cube. So pi cube minus pi cube 0, 0 and anything 0, that's why here we have written 0, and here also like that only. When you are applying the upper limit, you are getting minus 6, for x only we are applying the limit, so minus 6 pi cos n pi, cos n pi value is minus 1 power n divided by n cube. So this is our upper limit, minus lower limit is 0, so 0 and anything 0, here also 0. So we can cancel the 6 pi and 6 pi, so minus 1 power n by n cube. So here one minus is there, here it is minus 1 power n. So this can be written as minus 1 power n plus 1. So the required Fourier series is f of x is equal to sigma, this is an odd function, given f of x is an odd function, therefore a naught is 0, an is 0. So the required Fourier series contains only the sine term. So f of x is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity minus 1 power n plus 1 by n cube into sin nx. This is what the required Fourier series. Thank you for watching.